with all my complaining, however, this is actually really cool, actually. Like, both the battles that I've fought so far since the patch, both the multiplayer battles that I've fought have been really cool, and the single-player battles I've fought have been really cool as well, so, I don't know. Alrighty, I found someone. I found a 7-star. I found a bronze 7-star. This should be interesting. So I'm prestiged silver, he's bronze 7. Waterfalls map. Judging on my units, I'd go with this way of the Eco Iki. Hey, dude. Yes, I am. Waterfalls is full of charges. I don't need 3 spears, so let's get rid of that. That's baller. I know. It's very baller. I should have some veteran Boashigaru instead. These funds are extraordinarily limiting. What if I do this instead and put on 790. The best I can do is a lone sword, which is kind of what I had before. Okay, because infantry on this map is quite important, so I'll go with that. And my units are all have some pretty nice defense because of my way of the Eco Iki. And I'm not sure if the Hideous Mempo Mask is worth it. It does give my general +3 morale, but I think it would be better if I went with Renyo's Teachings to give my men really good defense. Either that or Blade Master. I think I'll go with Blade Master. I'll say good luck, have fun. What kind of avatar is he again? He is Famous Leader. Alrighty. So, this should be fun. Oh, I've played Jesse B954. I didn't know that that's this guy. I've played him before. When he was like a 4-star, 3-star, or something like that. Well, should be a good battle. It's an interesting scenario, having a prestiged guy play against a non-prestiged, non-10-star. Prestige, of course, definitely does not mean that you're better than non-prestige players. And I fear that that's what it's going to turn into. Like, people are going to be like, I'm prestige, so I'm better than you. Or he's not even prestiged. Because prestige is just a continuation of the game. That's why I did it. I just felt like it would be a continuation of the game, to make the game last longer. Because I had always kind of complained, half complained, you know, in my head about how after you finish it, after you unlock all the regions, that's it. It's done. Like, the whole entire Avatar Conquest is done. So, it's just a way of continuing it, and it definitely doesn't mean that I'm better than anyone, any non-prestige 10-star. In fact, Archangel's Ares, AA Ares, is pretty much not going to prestige, and he is better than I am, I would say that. He'd say that I was better than him, but I'd say he was better than me. So, yeah. Prestiging will be harder. So it gives you a bigger challenge than the guys who aren't prestige, but it doesn't mean that you're better, so clarification there. Waterfalls, of course, I'm going to start on the high ground, he's going to start on the high ground, we're going to rush each other, hopefully my swords and my Tetsubo warrior monk hero unit will win. And I really like how the hero unit doesn't cost all that much. Oh, look what he did, he played warrior monks receive -2 morale, doesn't really do too much to my warrior monk. He did play that thing that really hurt my swords, that's a shame. That's really saddening. There we go. And there we go. And there we go. See, the biggest problem with sword attendants is that they have so few men that if they lose the same number of men as a lone sword unit loses in a given amount of time, they will waver, because for them it's like losing half their unit, whereas for a lone sword it's like losing, you know, a quarter of their unit. So that's the big problem with lone sword, these attendant units. Okie dokie. So he thinks I'm going to bring warrior monks, which is a good thought, because warrior monks are not have been unnerfed. I have a question. Why is this a 4-star? It's 9 chevrons, not 4 chevrons. Does it just say 4 chevrons? It does. That's really weird. But anyways, let's see what he has. He has bows. He has some Bowashigaru. He's got some No-Dachi. Dang it. He's got some mounted gunners. What the heck? He's got some 9 out to wear on Kev. I wish I had brought more spears. I really wish I had brought more spears. Ugh. My light Kev could potentially take out his mounted gunners. That's what I'm going to attempt to do. Hopefully I can overwhelm his No-Dachi with sheer numbers. There's my ambush. Ah, he noticed it. Interesting. He's gonna let me catch his unit. Well, I guess I'll just charge him. So I'm just trying to overwhelm him. My guys are wavering, which is kind of annoying. Which is the problem with sword attendance again. Let's just try and flank him, get done with it. His No-Dachi are lasting, which is a big problem. But I think I got this. Yes, I have this. Yes, I have this. My general got into his mounted gunners. Alrighty. So, match 2. 2 wins. Let's see if my... Yep, it has its war cry. There we go. That's it. Done. I love these Tetsubo monks. They're actually really helpful because they have the war cry. Anyways, good game. Good game. Pretty awesome battle there. I'll save this one as well. Oh, this is 182, I think. Guessing. Yes. Alright, so that game I basically just used a rush tactic. I had far superior infantry, he had far superior cav, so I just basically did enough skirmishing with my light cav and my Yarashigaru just ran after him pretty much, which is a stupid tactic, but because of the, you know, bottlenecks, including the sword dojo and the cliffs, he wasn't really able to get around my guys in Hammer and Anvil. Now, his No-Dachi really put up a good fight there, and I can actually show you the statistics of his guys, because a really cool thing in here is, that I can actually show you what his statistics are on the unit statistics. Which is a new thing. Because he killed more than me. But I unlocked South Shinano. I unlocked Practice Grounds. And I didn't get a... Please tell me. Okay, good. I got a light cav. I don't want a light cav. Light cav are best as unveteran units. Alright, so you could see my Lone Swords were 9 chevron in the beginning. Okay. My Warrior Monk got 39 kills. Because my sword attendants did absolutely nothing. I want a sword attendant veteran. I think it would be kind of cool. But you can see here that his No-Dachi got 162. His warrior monks got 173 kills. His avatar's bodyguard, his mounted gunners got 25. So these guys were waste. These guys did very well. So anyways, I unlocked three practice grounds, and yeah, good game to Jesse. B954. I think I could go there. Yeah, I think I'll go for the that medicine guy. Simply because. Yeah, it's not. It's either that or the Sengoku Bune, and it's, you know, yeah, I don't want that. But trading post, that's my goal right there. Then after that, I'll probably head. Oh, what's this one right there? Armor? Don't want armor. Ugh, none of these are good. Armor. Either that or I could just go up there and train Fuku Cook. Then across the Sengoku Bune. I don't want the Sengoku Bune! All these are terrible. Oh well. And unfortunately with that battle, it was not good enough for me to skill up here. So, another battle to go, and then I will be two stars. Let's see. New army. This guy's injured, so let's remove. I need a new army. And my Katana Samurai costs a bazillion. Why do they cost that much? They didn't upgrade the... Oh, it's because it's way of the Ikuyuki and no trading post. Got it. Well, I think I should go with, you know, some solid spears. Spear. Then the Onabushi heroine. Then... God, those things, those sword attendants are terrible. But I guess I'll bring them one more time. Oh god, they're bad. I'll bring two of them. And one bow. That seems okay. Small. But hopefully these guys will hold me. I don't need this guy, because the only difference between him and him is upgraded bonus versus cav. So I don't need the bonus versus cav. I can ditch that guy for a cheaper one. Let's go for one of these 600 ones right there. Get rid of that. Go for a 600 one. I have slightly more money now. So it's actually a really good experience almost, because you really need to learn how to manage your army and, you know, cut down on size and not be over flamboyant about what units you're getting. Let's get some more. I could get a lone sword. Sounds nice. After every single battle, I just check my ranking. I don't know why. I'm ranked 233. Hum-de-dum. Mm-hmm. That's weird. Okay, Air Spears is the lighter ones. Oh my gosh. I'm so unused to not having these provinces conquered. Okay. Another match made. Actually, you know what? I'm just going to pause real quick for here and come back with a match made after I do one thing. Alright, so my video's finished rendering and and it's like in the middle of uploading. It was the DLC and patch changes, part 1 and part 2. They all had to render and upload, so that took a long time. So yeah, I've actually made like 15 videos today, like campaign, but if I haven't done campaign yet, then let me get ahead of myself. Anyways, we were about to fight a battle here. My third battle. I'm 2-0 right now. The first one against, you know, someone ranked 207, or I think that's what he was. It's been a long time now. 207 on the 1v1 ladder board and unprestiged 10 star. So that's pretty cool. Oh, geez, I'm fighting an unprestiged 4 star. Well, this should be fun. I think I'm going to keep my army the way it is. Floodplain. Got three spears, we've got two sword attendants, and a lone sword, Bowashigaru, and the Onabushi heroine. This guy has got journeyman, bowman, leader, swordsman, dishonorable character. It always amazes me how someone could be so stupid as to like rage quit three times in a row. Like, I can understand someone being stupid enough to rage quit once, but three times in a row? That takes real thick-headedness. Anyways, I've got the the Way of the Ikuiki and Renyo's teachings to give my guys the ultimate melee defense, at least my spears. These guys don't have quite as good melee defense, or melee attack at least, But it'll do. I just don't want them to rout instantaneously. So I've given them extra morale. I've given them plus 3 morale and plus... Whoa, what is it? I can't see it. Plus 3 morale, plus 7 melee defense. So, pretty fearsome. Good luck, have fun. Alrighty, so, I think, hopefully, if I can, you know, not totally suck, this could be 3-0, which would be very nice. I'd go all the way up to 2-star in one sitting. Yeah, I hope I can get up to 2-star. The sooner I can get to 3-star and use medium funds, the better, because as soon as I get that, I'll be able to use more and more veterans. Like, these four veterans, really, really, really costing me. Like, my army is very, very small, and it shouldn't be that small, but I'm using veterans, so. As soon as I get up to medium funds, then I'll be able to use some of my better veterans, which is kind of like the point of prestige. You can be, like, a 4-star and use 9 chevron, this and that, and this and that. So, I'm, gonna try and get to 3-star as quickly as possible.